GRA501 here. This is an older article from 2011, but it's came up again and I just find it very disturbing. Crowd control training to be held at San Diego University Thursday, August 4th with a police helicopter. Did you know that a couple hundred Explorer Scouts from around the state are in San Diego this week for training on how to be cops? And the training includes crowd control during an improvised riot, complete with sheriff deputies masquerading as rioters and the use of a police helicopter. The Explorer Scouts, aged 15 to 18, also are having training in arrest techniques, ethics, shooting at a firing range, investigation of traffic accidents, gangs, domestic violence, and narcotics. The scouts will also be involved with taking control of a street in La Jolla. This is all part of the 38th Annual San Diego County Law Enforcement Explorer Academy. And this year, it involves over 200 young scouts from 23 agencies. But who is paying for all this? This was the question I asked of contact person Gigi McCullough of the Lemon Grove Sheriff Substation, who is one of the staff responsible for the training. She replied that it is all donated time and supplies, that the individual scouts paid for some of it, their agencies paid for some, and the individual deputies involved in the training are all acting as volunteers. The scouts, I was told, had done fundraising over the past year for this year's academy. Is the helicopter from the Escondido Police Department also a volunteer? I still have this question. Why are San Diego County taxpayers picking up a bunch of costs for this training? And I have other questions and concerns, but not about the financial aspects, more of the ethics aspect. How ethical is it for our local sheriffs to be training these kids? Their training looks to be fun. Fun in the sun, fun in the barracks, fun at the barbecue. Yet police work is serious, sometimes deadly work. There are real police academies for this kind of training. Ah, but do you see, if successful, these kids will be on track to be recruited by various law enforcement agencies. Will these young pre-recruits also be educated in the fine points of the Bill of Rights? You know, the Fourth Amendment prohibitions against illegal search and seizure. Were these boys and girls receive expert training in the rights of suspects? I know the Sheriff's Department has many such experts. That's why only the guilty go to jail. But there's more. Will these youngsters be grilled in the nuances of protecting their communities from greedy corporations, corrupt and oppressive landlords, toxic polluters, and employers who violate workers' rights? Will the training involve how not to deal with a homeless guy, to not act like the six cops in Fullerton who just recently beat a homeless man to death? Or, unlike San Diego police officers who shot a well-known Ocean Beach homeless man to death in February 2003, and hopefully the training in riot control will offer lessons drawn from our very own Ocean Beach Collier Park riot. Plus, hopefully the training will get these young people ready to resist temptation and corruption, such has enveloped our own San Diego Police Department over the years. This is not a put down of police in general. We all know hardworking officers who care about their peoples and communities they serve. They're working stiffs like many of us. And the extremists on the right are attacking their union rights and protections. Plus, it's dangerous work. It's serious work. And it's work that needs an actual academy for the training. I just find this really, really interesting that this is a crowd control training. And these are just young kids. I mean, they put them on a firing line. They're teaching them how to use guns. I can't even imagine that there were that many parents that, agreed to let their children be involved with this. To me, it's just kind of like setting up these kids so that when the shit hits the fan and people do start standing up for their rights, that these kids are gonna think that they're trained enough to deal with the neighbor who has a gun and turn him in or do something worse. Anyway, this is just really disturbing to me. These little boys should be out playing baseball. They should be running track. They should be down at the beach surfing. They should be doing anything but something that has to do with this kind of violence. Frightening.